Now we will look at the face. A puffy face should make you think of three common conditions: renal edema, myxedema, and steroid faces. Notice the typical renal edema, maximum around the eyes, more in the mornings, in a case of nephrotic syndrome. If it is of sudden onset with scanty red urine, think of acute glomerulonephritis. See the distribution of edema, which is mainly in the loose tissues of the face with minimal dependent edema of the legs. Notice the myxedema face. Note the dull look on the face. And though we cannot hear her hoarse and slow voice in this cassette, I will demonstrate the slow relaxation of the ankle jerk, which is as confirmatory of myxedema as the costly T3, T4, TSH studies. See how slowly the muscle relaxes. 100% diagnostic of myxedema. This is another patient of hypothyroidism. Though it is uncommon in males, that dull look in the eyes is characteristic. Steroid face is also similar and should be thought of if the patient is on steroids, say for bronchial asthma or some skin disease. This is Rhesus sardonicus of tetanus. It gives an appearance of laughing due to contraction of the facial muscles. I will demonstrate the other signs of tetanus also. I am asking her to open her mouth, but she can't. She has lockjaw. Lockjaw is the earliest sign of tetanus. See the neck stiffness. See the stiffness of the muscles of the hands. So in every case of muscle stiffness, lockjaw and convulsions, keep in mind tetanus. See the stiffness of the legs. And see that even the abdominal muscles are stiff. Bell's palsy or facial nerve palsy. A healthy person suddenly finds on waking up one day that the mouth is deformed and one eye is not closing. See the absence of wrinkles on the left side of forehead on looking up. Ask the patient to close the eyes and note the turning up of the eyeball on closing the eyes, termed as Bell's sign. Tell the patient to smile and the affected angle of the mouth does not move. Let him blow up his cheeks and air leaks through the left angle of mouth. This is left facial palsy. If this patient has pain or some pathology in the ear, refer the patient to an ENT surgeon. Otherwise, treat him with high doses of vitamin B-plex and steroids for 2 to 3 weeks. Parotid swellings are also often seen in practice. Mumps is very common in children with diffuse swelling of both parotids, which needs only symptomatic treatment. Benign mixed parotid tumors such as these are seen to be present under the ear lobule for several years. If the swelling raises the ear lobule, it is definitely arising from the parotid gland. When parotid swelling is present, also look for facial palsy, and the patient must be referred for surgery, especially if the swelling is long-standing, large, nodular, or adherent. See a large and nodular parotid tumor in this old man. Malignancy must be ruled out.